A very good morning to all dear students. A good communication is the bridge between confusion and clarity. With this pandemic, we are becoming more and more techno-savvy. Today, let's learn how to write an email. I know you all have heard about an email. A lot have also seen it or used it. So without any delay, let's get started. An email or electronic mail is a system which enables us to convey our ideas or share our experiences with others. It is the fastest way of communication. When I say the fastest, it means just a click. So, with just a click of a button, the mail is received by the person to whom you want to convey a message. So, for an email, you need the sender who sends the message, the receiver to whom the mail is sent, an internet connection. It is not only used professionally but also in personal lives for sending immediate information. Emails can be divided into two categories, formal mails and informal mails. Informal category are the emails sent as business mails from or to companies, government departments, offices, educational institutions, etc. When talking about informal emails, they are usually mails sent to family, relatives, friends, etc. Now let us understand how do we write the email. So, what actually is the format for writing an email or its structure? An email is divided into two parts. The first part in which you write information like the date, sender's email, receiver's email and the subject. Apart from that, we also have the body of the mail. Here it contains the message and the closing part. It can be a formal message or an informal message. So let's discuss the format and what all is included in an email. The first thing that is there is the date and the sender's email. When we log into an email, this information is automatically filled. So the image that we see for writing the mail will start with 2, in which you fill in the email address of the receiver of the email. After 2, if we want to send it to somebody else also, we have CC, which means carbon copy. So if we are writing an email and we want somebody else also to pay attention to that information, we send a CC to the other person. We also have BCC, which means blind carbon copy. It means that if you want to send information to somebody without the receiver knowing about it, then you can send a BCC to the other person, and then we have the subject. The subject is the most important as it gives a quick idea or a clear clue about the content of the email to the receiver. So whenever you check the mail, immediately what you see is the subject. Then we have the salutation, which means referring to somebody. We usually use dear sir or madam, and if it's to a friend, we write just the name. Then we can write the body of the email, furnishing all the information in a soft tone, and end the email with a pleasant statement. Once we have finished, we can send the email. Let's quickly go through some tips for writing an email. The email address should be proper. The subject should be relevant to the content of the email. The tone of the email should be safe, soft, and the content should be clear. Once we have started writing the paragraphs or the body of the email, we should keep in mind that the main idea should be in separate paragraphs. We should avoid spelling mistakes and grammatical errors to create a good impression on the receiver. Once we have completed writing the email, we need to close it with regards or thank you. Let's understand it with an example. From jignapatel@yahoo.com to mayur57@yahoo.com. The subject is touring holiday. Hello, how are you? I hope your father has recovered from his illness. Some college friends of mine are visiting your area soon for a week's touring holiday. They would like to travel around and learn about your local area and its history. Can you tell me about some of the places they could visit? What's the best way to travel around? Car, bike or coach? Please do let me know. Awaiting for your reply, Jigna. So dear children, with this we come to the end of this topic. Thoroughly go through the video, understand the format and actually write an email. Practice it by writing a small email to your friend. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.